Welcome to Enjoy English. I am Alice.
大家好，我是 Bernice.
And today we are on day two of our culture lesson on Torii, a Japanese gate between heaven and earth. Yesterday we said that it is one of the important symbols of Japanese culture, right? If we see a Torii, we automatically think Japan, right? And also maybe Shintoism or Japan's culture.
所以我们讲的这个文化呢就是在讲这个鸟居。那我们也在第一天的课程提过，这个鸟居呢就是红色，大部分是红色，然后呢很大的一个门。那这个门呢主要就是像一个边界，隔开人的世界跟天界的一个边界。好，所以我们今天呢会对于这个鸟居呢会有更多一层的了解。
So let's take a break and get right to it.
好的。
Torii, a Japanese gate between heaven and earth. There are over 100,000 torii gates in Japan. However, if you are planning a trip to Japan, some torii stand out from the rest. Tokyo's Meiji Shrine was built in 1915 to honor a popular Japanese emperor. The shrine is located in a natural spot surrounded by forest and trees.At the entrance to the shrine is a huge wooden torii that has the emperor's seal on it. During Japanese New Year, it's visited by more than 3 million people. Kyoto's Fushimi Inari Shrine is a must-see attraction if you want to become rich. It was made to honor Inari, the Japanese goddess of business. It features a stretch of 5,000 smaller,Red Torii Gates. Visitors can carve their names into the Torii for good luck. The floating Torii of the Itsukushima Shrine on Itsukushima Island might be one of the most impressive sights in all of Japan. It is one of the oldest Torii as well. It was built in shallow water to make it look like it's floating. It's a popular spot for taking photos,because its appearance changes depending on the tide and time of day. In the right light, it seems almost otherworldly, as a torii should.
All right, let's get started. So we have, there are over 100,000 torii gates in Japan, which is quite a large number. I mean, Japan's not that big, right? But there's over 100,000, so more than 100,000. That's quite a lot.
没错，这就很像台湾的寺庙一样。你看台湾这么小一个地方，可是我们的庙宇呢，那走个几步你就可以看到，哇，好多好多不同的庙，对不对？所以呢，日本他们也是这个样子，因为他们有的他们的宗教的信仰，所以他们光是这个鸟居呢就有超过10万座的鸟居在这个日本这个土地上面，所以你可以知道可见它数量之多了。
However, if you are planning a trip to Japan, some torii stand out from the rest. So if you stand out from something, that means you are a little different in some way, like you catch people's eye. Usually we say like you stand out from the crowd, right? Maybe becauseyou know, you're so beautiful, or you wear such wonderful clothes, right?
Like, I'm so tall.
Yeah, stands out from the crowd.
没错，所以刚刚老师在解释这个 stand out from something, 意思就是说你是那个特别站得比人家出来的那一个，所以你表示你特别显眼，你特别不一样，你特别突出的意思。好，可能是因为你很美，也可能是因为，当然你很丑也有可能。好，等等等等的原因。好，所以你特别的显眼。好，所以他就说了，然而呢，如果你想要打算计划去日本来玩一下的话呢，有这么多超过十万座的鸟居，你总不能十万个都去看嘛，对不对？所以它里面呢就说，有一些呢这些鸟居呢，其实呢 the rest 就是跟其他的好有一些不太一样，特别的显著的，特别不一样的，那你可以去好好的瞧一瞧。
Tokyo's Meiji Shrine was built in 1915 to honor a popular Japanese emperor. So if you honor someone or something, that means you're kind of like paying respect to them. You're kind of like remembering them in a good way, right? You like honor, do something, or you have something to honor someone else. So usually like here, a shrine to honor an emperor. It's like in their name, in their respect.
没错。好，所以第一个呢，我们要来介绍这个鸟居。各位听好了，你如果要去日本呢，好，现在 Bernice 老师来帮你做个导航了。第一座呢，你要去的呢，就是在 Tokyo 东京的一个叫做明治神宫。我只知道明治冰淇淋。好好 ，OK， 好，明治神宫呢，这个宫呢，它的时间点呢是建造在1915年。那为什么建造这个神宫呢？主要是因为他要 honor， 刚刚老师讲的 honor 就是你要尊崇这个人，好，他主要尊崇的就是日本很受欢迎的他们的日本天皇，所以呢，这个既然是要尊崇他们的，纪念他们的日本天皇，那你当然要去瞧一瞧这个宫咯。
The shrine is located in a natural spot surrounded by forest and trees.So if you're surrounded by something, that means it's all around you. Like right now, we're surrounded by green walls, I guess.
Yeah.
Right? You're surrounded by something.
没错。所以呢，这个地方呢，这个神社的地方呢，哈，是在哪里呢？他说他的位置呢，主要是位在比较大自然的环境。好，所以如果你喜欢接近大自然的这个宫，你就可以先去来这个参观一下。然后它的周遭 surrounded 就是它的四周呢，都被什么给环绕着呢？它一定要用被动式哈，被这个所谓的森林啦，还有很多的树，所以呢，你就可以接近大自然，而且同时呢，又可以去参观这样的一个神宫。
At the entrance to the shrine is a huge wooden torii that has the emperor's seal on it.So a seal, in this case, is not the cute animal, a seal.
No.
Okay, like the ones that clap their hands. No, this is a seal as in a seal for letters. It's kind of old-fashioned. Usually it's like it's some sort of stamp that they stamp either letters or official documents. You have a seal. So this is the emperor's seal. So it's most important.
所以这边呢，千万别误会这个，你们以为是日本天皇的宠物。不是那只海豹。OK. 它主要是在讲那个皇帝他们都会有一个章，一个大印章，就像我们的话是皇帝都会有一个玉玺这样子蹦盖下去哈。所以他的意思说，这个神宫的门口 entrance 就是你要一进去这个地方，要进去这个神宫的这个地方的门口呢，你就会看到一个很巨大的木质的哈这一个鸟居，所以这个鸟居它是用木头所盖出来的。而且这个鸟居的特色就是呢，它在上面呢有一个这个天皇的印章，嘣盖在上面，所以你就知道哦 ，OK， 我现在到的这个鸟居呢，就是专门是这个里面是尊崇这个日本天皇的一个鸟居。
During Japanese New Year, it's visited by more than 3 million people.
Wow!
So Japanese New Year, I think I've been told it's different, a different time of year than Chinese New Year. So that's why they specified, right, is Japanese New Year. Yeah, more than 3 million people. Again, that's really, like, really a lot of people considering the island is not that big. So yeah, pretty impressive.
就跟我们的 Chinese New Year 是一样的哈，我们过我们的中国农历节，我们也是会去一些寺庙啦，或庙里面去拜拜。那他们日本人也是一样，他们日本呢，在他们日本的新年期间呢，光是去参观这个日本天皇的这个明治神宫的人呢，就超过了300万的观光人次啊，所以表示大家都想要去这里面，可能祈求平安啦，祈求幸运啦，等等等的。总之，他们会特别挑在日本的这个过年的时期去参观这个神宫。
So let's pause for a bit and then come back. Okay, on to paragraph two. So we have Kyoto's Fushimi Inari Shrine is a must-see attraction if you want to become rich. Well, I guess probably most of us want to become rich.
Yes.
There's not many people who say, no, I don't want to become rich. Most of us do. So, yeah, I guess we should go see this shrine then, right?
没错，这种庙呢，就像我们的叫财神庙。啊，你去那边就是要祈求富贵的啊，要多赚一点钱的。好，那这种庙怎么能不去呢？好，所以第二个地方呢，我们讲的是这个在京都的哈，它的中文叫做福建道和神社。好，这个神社呢，它是一个 must see， 就是你一定要去的 attraction 的一个 place 的一个地点。 为什么呢？因为大家都想变有钱人，只是说今天呢，这个神到底照顾到哪一个人，对不对？大家都说啊，我希望有钱，我希望有钱。那到底谁能够有钱呢？当然不是嘴巴说一说啦，你还是要认真的工作，对不对？不过呢，你想要祈求说，哎，你今天赚钱的比较顺利，你想要致富，那么这一个京都的福建道和神社就是一个必去的景点。
It was made to honor Inari, the Japanese goddess of business. Excuse me. So it's a female god, right? So a goddess of business probably would know a lot about money. So it makes sense that maybe you'd visit her if you want to become rich.
对，所以呢，这边是他这边这个神社呢，供奉的是女神哦，哈。那么这个地方呢，主要他 made 就是他建造起来的时候，他的目的呢，就是为了要供奉他们日本的这一个女。女神，那这个女神呢，就是名字就叫道和。那么她呢是日本的一个商业女神，所以她就是跟 business 相关的。所以如果呢你是自己是这个上班族啦，或者是你自己在这个开生意的人、做生意的人，你就会想要去那边好好的祈求一下，可以赚大钱。
It features a stretch of 5,000 smaller red torii gates. So features in this case kind of means like.It has something, but it's like the special, right? So like, you know, in this case, right, a shrine isn't that different than other shrines, but here it features, it has something special, which it has 5,000 smaller red torii gates. That's pretty special.
没错，所以这边老师刚刚解释这个 feature, 他就是说这个神社有它的特色的地方。那么特别的地方呢，就是它里面呢有 a stretch of, stretch 我们知道原本是延伸出去的意思，所以它就是有一大片的，你眼睛也看到很多很多的怎么样，里面总共有5000个比较小一点的这一个所谓的红色的鸟居。所以你看它一个神社，然后里面你可以看到有5000个鸟居，所以可见它是非常非常的不一样的。
Visitors can carve their names into the torii for good luck. So if you carve, right, usually it means you take a knife and you like...Carve it, I guess, into wood usually, right? Or into stone if it's a really sharp knife, right? And you carve either your name, right? Or you carve a picture, right? You're carving into wood or stone usually.
对，所以他的意思就是说，如果你去参观这个地方，因为他鸟居很多嘛，哈，有5000个，所以呢，你呢想要祈求说，哎，我想要赚多赚一点钱，你这时候就把你的名字 Bernice 刻在上面 ，OK， 就刻在其中一个这个鸟居上面。那目的呢，就是 for good luck， 就是希望可以哎好运一点啦，可以多赚一点钱。我想应该都刻满了吧，可能没有位置，要把别人的先擦掉，然后再把它刻上去也有可能。好，总之呢。你如果想要祈求好运，想要赚大钱，就是把你的名字刻在上面。
So let's take a break and then come back to it. All right, on to our final paragraph. So we have the floating torii of the Itsukushima Shrine on Itsukushima Island might be one of the most impressive sights in all of Japan. So floating.To float is like when you're in water, right? You don't sink to the bottom, right? You float and you like stay on top, right? So if you know how to swim, you usually know how to float so you don't go glug 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 into the water, right? You stay on top. So here though, it's a floating torii, quite interesting.
没错，所以接下来我们要介绍的这第三个这个神社呢，它基本上呢就是 floating.漂浮在那边的哈，因为呢它就是像老师刚刚讲，它不是沉下，不是会我往下沉，没有，它就是飘在那旁边，感觉有水在那边。好，那这个神社呢，它是一个非常这个让人印象很深刻嘛，因为你看一般我们可能看到神社可能在山上或者可能在陆地上，可它不是，它是漂浮在水上面的哈。那这个神社呢，它叫做岩岛神社的大鸟居，好，叫做大鸟居。那么这个神社呢，也是一个必看的景点，因为呢，它是让人家印象非常深刻的。
It is one of the oldest torii as well. So not only is it impressive because it's floating, it's also one of the oldest one. And again, we saw that this was goes back to what? Dates back to the 8th century? Mm. So that's pretty old, pretty impressive.
所以接下来呢，他讲说为什么这一个大鸟居啊，好，可以让人家这么样的印象深刻，就是因为它是日本所有的这些鸟居里面最古老的一座，所以你非要去看一下不可。
嗯。It was built in shallow water to make it look like it's floating. Okay, so it's not necessarily floating on top of the water, right? But because it's in shallow water, which means it's not deep, right? In a swimming pool, you usually have two ends. You have the deep end, which you can easily sink, right? Mm. Or you have the shallow end, where your feet can usually touch the bottom.
没错，所以这边讲到一个字叫做 shallow. Shallow 这个字就是比较浅的，水没有那么深的。好，所以呢，为什么你会觉得它好像哎漂浮在上面？因为它涨潮的时候啊，你就会看到它哎，感觉这一个鸟居就漂浮在水面上。他说，主要呢就是因为这个鸟居它建造的地方就是在潜水的地方。好，那所以呢，你会让它感觉好像你远远的这样子看，哎，好像这个神社呢，这个鸟居呢是漂浮在水面上的那个感觉。
It's a popular spot.For taking photos because its appearance changes depending on the tide and time of day. So if something's depending on something, that means basically it like kind of relies on it or it kind of like it changes based on whether the tide is in or out or whether like the sun is up or down, right? So usually depending on means it's like it's connected to this, right? This will change.If this changes.
嗯，所以呢，这边的意思就是说呢，因为这一个岩岛神社的大鸟居呢，它本身呢就是感觉像一个漂浮的一个神社，所以呢，大家就很喜欢去那边照相啊，所以它是一个非常受欢迎的一个照相的景点，就是因为它的 appearance， 它的外观会改变。为什么会改变呢？主要是 depend on， 就是取决于，就是它以它为作为一个基础，就是每一天你会有涨潮、退潮，还有那个时间点的不同。所以呢，哎，你可能早上的时候你看这个神社，它可能是这个样子。那接下来你可能下午或晚上你去看，哎，它又是不同样的一个面貌，就是因为它一直不断的在改变它的外观，所以大家很喜欢去这个地方照相。
嗯。Lastly, we have, in the right light, it seems almost otherworldly, as a Tori should. Mm. So this word otherworldly, it's kind of something we use only for like really special or strange things, right? Because it makes it, basically it means like, it looks like it's from another world, right? It looks like it's...From like you know some alien planet, so it's otherworldly.
嗯，好，所以呢，意思就是说呢，如果你今天去照相的时候呢，哎，你这个光线呐、啊、取得很对的时候呢，哎呦，这一个岩岛神社的大鸟居被你照起来呢，似乎呢就很像怎么样呢 ？Otherworldly 这个字。Other， 然后加上 world， 再加上 ly， 这是一个形容词，好，就是表示哇，好像。非凡间所有，有没有？好像天上才可以看得到，所以我们中文把它翻成好像超脱尘世的那个感觉，哇！但是呢，这个感觉其实呢，就是鸟居本来的那个 should， 就它原本就应该是这个样子嘛。因为我们讲了这个 gate， 它就是隔开人世跟天堂的一个界限，所以本来就是应该看起来想说，哇！世界上你看不到这样的一个东西，所以呢，你去了这个岩岛神社的大鸟居，你更会有这样的一个感觉。
All right, let's take a break and then talk about vocabulary.
好的。
Okay, let's talk about vocabulary now. So our first word is stand out from.So again, we say you want to stand out from the crowd, right? The crowd maybe is all wearing pink, but you are wearing blue, so you stand out from the crowd.
没错，所以 stand out 就刚刚讲，你是比别人那个站出来特别不一样的。所以呢 ，from 就是从一个群体里面，所以意思就是说你从这个里面你看出来是比较最突出的、很明显的、显眼的。
Mm-hmm.Next, we have honor, and in this case, we use it as a verb, right? So if you want to honor someone, like maybe you go to a temple and you will light some incense to honor your ancestors or to honor some gods.
没错，这边的 honor 是当动词的意思，就是你要去尊崇啦，你要去这个就是我们讲的，可能点一个这个香去纪念他，这时候我们就用到 honor。
Next, we have surround. So again, if we something's surrounding you, it's all around you. Like a common phrase we use is surround sound system, right? Like if the speakers sound like they're all around you, even though it's not.
对，这边也是当动词围绕的意思。不过通常我们有的时候我们会把这个字拿来用被动式，好 ，be surrounded by， 就是你的周遭被什么东西环绕着。
Next, we have seal. Again, not the cute, chubby seals, right? But here we have a seal, like an official sort of stamp. In the old days, like, you could use a seal to like, seal a letter, or they sealed important documents. But important people, right, like kings or emperors, have important official seals.
没错，这边的 seal 呢，当名词的意思就是指这个印章，哈，盖下去的这个印章。那本来呢，我们也知道它当名词也可以表示可爱的那个海报，哈，但在这里呢，并不是这个意思。
All right, then we have feature. So again, if you like feature, and this is a verb in this case, so if you feature something, that means like it's special, it's like the highlight. You want to put a little emphasis on it or a little focus on it.
没错，所以这边当动词的 feature 呢，就是以它为一个很明显的特色。
Next, we have floating. So again, if you're sinking, glug, glug, glug into the water, right? But if you're floating, that's the opposite. You're staying on top of the water.
没错，所以 float 的意思就是漂浮在上面的意思。
Next, we have shallow. Again, with the pools or like water, we have shallow end of the water, right? Where your feet can probably touch the ground.Or the deep end, where you have to learn to swim, otherwise you'll sink.
没错，所以 shallow 的就是比较浅的，好，这个地方。那你可以指一个人，这个人很肤浅，知道吗？讲话你觉得好像没什么学问的感觉，也可以这么说。所以 shallow 当形容词浅的，或者是形容人的话，就是肤浅的。
And then our final word we have is depending on. So if you depending, a phrase we often use a lot is depending on the weather,I might go outside today, right? If it rains, maybe I won't, but if it's sunny, I will. So it's depending on the weather.
对，所以刚才老师的意思就是说取决于，就是说，哎，看这个天气的状况。天气如果好，我们就出去玩；天气不好，我就待在家里面。所以这时候我们就用到 depend on something.
And that's all we have today. So we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.